7 diapers in one night. Pam has been an absolute star. Coffee at this time in the morning should be both inspirational and high octane.
Windy this morning, 15 to 20 out of the north, gusting up to 30. So it's gonna be pretty lumpy. You can see right here, it's flat along the reef, but a lot bigger offshore. What you can do is you can run the beach pretty close inside, and it's pretty flat, you can see right here. But further off, you see the Gulf Stream there. It's standing up a little bit because we got a north wind at 30, gusting to 30, 15 to 20 right now. But if you run the beach right here, you know, close off, you're pretty sheltered, and then turn out, go out to the reef, take your hits, and Ryan's getting the fenders in here, looking good. Nice day, beautiful day on the water. Port Everglades, Miami, and the port down there is actually one of the busiest ports in the world. A lot of cruise ships depart from here to all over the Caribbean, and especially down in Miami. There's actually a YouTuber who does cruise flights with his drone. He's a YouTuber that does cruise ship chase. Check it out. It's pretty cool. He comes down here, flies his drone, and checks the schedule when these guys leave, and then gives you some close-ups, flies about 4 miles offshore and comes back. So pretty cool. Check it out. And there is the first kite out. Second kite going out now. I'm gonna fish up to 6 baits today. Quick tip here on the kites, guys. First, attach the hook to your rod and reel. Second, take your solid ring above your kite float and clip it to the kite clip. Third, deploy your kite. Leave your fishing reel in free spool with the clicker on, and deploy the kite, and repeat the process 1, 2, and 3 until all your kite clips and fishing rods are out to their furthest point that you want to fish that kite. Then, and only then, deploy your bait one at a time and reel up until your bait is up to and under the kite where you want it. This process makes it a lot easier. Sailfish bite was slow, so we came over here to the stink hole, as we call it, or the Rolls Bowl. It's a sewer outlet, but the bite was really good out here sometimes. Wouldn't eat anything, but I wouldn't eat anything that's over here, though, I tell you that. Well, you can catch a lot, but you're not gonna eat it. I tell you what, it is absolutely honking out here. It is windy.
Yeah, yeah.
Getting buried in monster jacks right now, tearing through our goggle eyes on our normal sailfish spot. Here you go, Ryan. Hold that sucker up this way. Me and Ryan knocking down the jacks back to back offshore, solid 20 pounders.
All day, all day. All day.
Uh. Got a couple minutes here. Gonna feed these tarpon here at 15th Street Fishery. They're huge. Gotta see these things. And then we're gonna go to the beach. It's Baby Fraser's first time to the beach. And we're taking Pam and my mother and father, so that should be fun. I just had an interesting call, good call from a friend of mine, Scott Hamilton, Fly Fishing Extremes up in Palm Beach. Catches all these migrating sharks on fly. There's thousands of them that school up and migrate down the beach in February, March. We're gonna get together and lay the smackdown on some of these tarpon around Miami and Government Cut on fly too. Our first trip to the beach since baby Fraser was born. There he is. First trip. 13 days ago, we were right here, and Pam was pregnant, and now baby Fraser is here. We have mom and dad behind us here, following along, getting some fresh air today.